Good morning, eKids. We're so excited to hang out with you guys this morning. My name is Carson, and one of my favorite things to do on a Sunday morning is hang out with you guys, and I get to do that today. So thanks for joining us. Why don't you go ahead and stand up wherever you are and sing these songs out with us.
Shit. eKids, I'm Addie.
And I'm Brian.
And we're here to tell you guys a story set in the desert.
Ooh, the dessert. I can't believe we're starting the story at dessert. Like the dessert aisle?
No.
Oh, I love it. I love it. I love dessert. Let's see here. Ice cream?
No.
Or cake?
No.
Don't tell me. What about ice cream cake?
No, not dessert. Desert.
Oh, okay.
It's desert. Like hot sun, sand everywhere.
Like whoosh.
Yeah. Traveling through the hot, dry desert was a very special group of people. They were God's people called the Israelites, led by Joshua. God took very good care of them, and Joshua's job was to lead the people through the desert to a wonderful new home that God had promised them. So there they were, the Israelites, led by Joshua, traveling through the hot, dry sand with their cows.
Moo.
And their donkeys.
Hee-haw.
And their camels.
What sound does a camel make?
I don't know. Just make something up.
Okay,
out of all the sounds.
I mean, they make that sound.
Okay, anyways, after years of traveling through the desert, they finally arrived at the promised land.
Ta-da!
But there was a really big problem. The land was full of evil people.
I'm an evil person.
And before they could even move into it, they had to get rid of them. And the first city they were going to fight was a huge city called Jericho.
Jericho!
The city of Jericho was enormous. It had massive walls that went all the way around the city, and it was guarded by a huge army.
Oh, ten hut.
And now, the wicked people of Jericho saw the Israelites approaching the city, so they closed the gates.
Cha-ching.
Got to their battle stations.
Cha-ching.
And prepared for war.
I'm ready to go.
I know you're going right into this big epic battle scene, but they didn't have those things.
Me? No. No, I wasn't going to do that. No, ma'am.
Okay, just checking. So, the Israelites were like, let's go.
Uh-oh.
Wait, what are you doing?
Sorry, I couldn't help it. I mean, the Israelites, they were getting ready for battle and, like, battle stations, and I was just too excited.
They did say that, but you gotta listen to me. It says right here, the people of Jericho were ready to fight. But the Israelites had a very different plan. God told Joshua very specific instructions. They were to march around all day, every day, for 6 straight days. And then, on the 7th day, they were to march around the city 7 times and blow their trumpets. And shout at the top of their lungs.
Shout!
What? No, that's just, bring it down a little bit.
A little bit?
Okay. A little bit.
Okay, sorry.
Okay. God said that if they followed these instructions, Jericho could be theirs. So, the next day, Joshua led the people to Jericho's massive walls, and they began to march.
Here we go.
And they walked around.
Check. 2, 3,
some
4.
More.
1, 2,
and
3, 4.
And some more.
S'mores? Oh, I love s'mores. How about mine with extra chocolate?
No, just keep marching.
Oh, okay, fine. 2, 3,
they kept
4.
Walking until finally,
2, 3, 4. 2,
the next
3,
day, they did
4.
The same.
What? 2, 3,
and they
4.
Walked around the city of Jericho again.
Oh.
The next day. And the next day. And the next day.
Still walking.
And they walked around the city just like God had instructed them to do. And then, on the 7th day, they walked around 7 more times.
7 times?
And the people of Jericho were really confused. They were thinking, why don't these people just fight us? Why do they keep walking around our city? But Joshua knew to follow God's instructions, and that's exactly what they did. After that, the Israelites blew their trumpets.
Okay. Hold on. Oh, I'm a little tired and winded and honestly a little dizzy.
Yeah.
Okay.
And they blew their trumpets. And shouted at the top of their lungs.
Shout!
Too loud.
Shout!
Still too loud.
I'm sorry.
Anyway, something amazing happened. The ground began to rumble.
Rumble noises.
And the walls began to crack.
Crackling noises.
Joshua and all of God's people watched as the huge wall of Jericho began tumbling down.
Falling noises.
Jericho was defenseless, and Joshua and his army rushed into the city and wiped them all out.
Can I?
Yeah. Now, this is where the story gets really interesting. After Jericho was wiped out, Joshua and his men gathered all the gold, all the silver, and anything of value, and they piled it up in the middle of the city.
Ooh, Okay, there we go.
Okay.
I'm ready. Like 50-50?
No.
Okay, fine. 70-30?
No.
Fine, you can have it all.
No, it wasn't like that. See, God gave a different instruction to Joshua, and this one was even more important than the first. God told him not to keep anything in the city.
Oh, like nothing?
Nope,
like nothing. Not even like a souvenir?
No, they were to sacrifice everything from Jericho as an offering to God.
Oh, man. Not even a bobblehead or like a shirt that says Jericho is here?
No, let me explain it. It's kind of like when we pay our tithes. God said you can keep everything in the rest of the cities, but you got to give it all to the first.
Okay, I guess I'm okay with that.
Okay, so everybody followed God's instructions. Well, almost everybody. There was this one man named Achan who wanted to keep some for himself, so he took a little bit of gold here and there, and he hid it in his pockets.
Ooh, that's not good. But, I mean, it's going to be okay. Like, Joshua's found out. He was busted.
Not right away. You see, after they were finished with Jericho, they moved on to the next city, and it wasn't even close to as big as Jericho. They didn't have huge walls, and even their armies weren't that strong. When the Israelites arrived, Joshua sent his best soldiers to take over the city.
Whooshing!
As Joshua's men approached the city, it looked like they were going to dominate. It would be easy as pie.
Pie. I love pie. It's my favorite, actually.
We're just talking about how easy it's going to be.
Oh. So there's no pie?
No. They got out their swords.
Shwing!
And started fighting.
On guard!
But instead of wiping out the city, they started to lose. Men even died. The rest of the men rested, and the battle was lost.
I'm dying. Oh,
Brian, what are you doing?
I'm dead.
You're not dead. I hear you talking.
I'm not alive.
I can see your mouth moving.
It's not my mouth.
Get up here.
And I'm alive again.
Anyways, Joshua asked God why this happened. Why couldn't he defeat the small city? And God told him someone disobeyed, and he kept something from Jericho. And because of that, they lost God's protection, and his blessing was gone. Joshua gathered everybody and eventually found out it was Achan. He got in really big trouble, and after they were done dealing with Achan, Joshua went to his tent and prayed. He asked God for forgiveness, and that's exactly what God gave him. He forgave the Israelites and restored their blessings. And after that, Joshua's men marched back into the battle, in through the gates, drew their swords, and began fighting.
Cha-cha, cha-cha!
It was a piece of cake this time around.
Oh, cake. I love cake. I'm so excited for cake.
No, not cake. We're talking about how easy it's going to be.
Oh, fine. No cake.
But they did defeat the city. And just like God said, they got to keep all the gold and silver inside. God helped Joshua and the Israelites with a great victory, and they knew how important it was to follow God's plan. Sometimes it's easier to make it about us and what we want, but God has an awesome life for us.
Oh, he wants to give us cake.
Yeah, he wants to give us cake and other good things. Okay. When we follow him and are about his plan for us, good things will happen, just like Joshua. The end.
Hey, eKids, what a fun story we just heard from Addie and Brian. This week, our verse comes from Deuteronomy 13, verse 4. It says, "It is the Lord your God you must follow, and him you must respect. Keep his commands and obey him. Serve him and hold fast to him." This week, we want to remember, we can kind of feel like Joshua and the Israelites. We can kind of feel right now that we just keep doing the same thing over and over. We're at our houses, kind of like Joshua and the Israelites had to keep walking around the walls of Jericho. But we need to remember that we can follow God every day, even when we're not at church, or even when it feels like we're doing the same thing. God is still with us and we can follow him. Remember to read your word and pray to him daily. Let's pray now. Heavenly Father, thank you so much that you let us follow you. Thank you for being an amazing leader. God, I just pray over every eKid this week that God, we remember no matter what's going on that we can follow you. We love you and we pray all this in your name. Amen. Hey, thank you so much for joining us for church online this weekend. We can't wait to see what you guys are doing this week with your verse. Have your parents post it on social media so we can see how you're remembering it. And remember, just keep coming back. We'll see you guys next weekend. Have a great week.